Diesel Weasel.
That's me, man. That's me. Let me show my guns. Is that what you were doing, man? You're showing your guns, stretching out. Look at those muscles. He's gained some good weight. Some good muscle weight while we've been home. So happy. After I took him back from that, what do you call those things, kennel? After I went to Seattle, he had lost so much weight because I guess I wasn't there and he wasn't eating. So he's gained all his weight back. He's so healthy again. His coat is shiny. Hardly shedding anything. Such a good boy. Now I'm going to go into Winnipeg, okay? I'm going to go look at moose bumpers and big bright moose lights. Yeah. I need you to hold the fort, okay? Can you do that? Can you do that for me? I need you to use your sniffer and your high frequency ears to make sure that no danger comes near. Can you do that? You bark at anyone who comes on the yard. Good boy. Good boy. You going to be okay?
Oh, of course I'll be okay, man. I'm going to have a party in here.
No parties. If you do, clean up after yourself. I don't want to clean up. Party. Kids. So yeah, I'm going to make my way into Winnipeg. I don't think they got a showroom of moose bumpers, but I want to go talk to the people who make them. And they want to sell me one. They want to make one for me, actually, and sell it to me. Which is cool, so I get one made specifically just for me. And I also want to go look at this one chrome shop that I know is out in Headingley, way on the other side of the city. I know. But I've been wanting to do this the whole time I've been home and I haven't done it yet, so looks like I'll be picking up my truck tomorrow, end of day, if everything goes right. There's flies in here, just close the door. If everything goes all right, tomorrow, end of day, the truck should be done. It's got a brand new hood on it. It was the same price as that used hood, apparently. There's bugs in here. So brand new hood. They're just putting the headlight assembly together today. Everything's painted. They're just doing all the final little details today. And what did they say they're doing tomorrow yet? But they said it should be ready by the end of the day tomorrow. So guys, we're almost back to trucking. So now I'm going to go look into some moose bumpers and protecting that investment of a truck I have. I don't know if I'm going to buy it or not because it's $3,400, guys. It's expensive to get one of those things, but I really don't want to finance it. I hate financing. I hate debt. But here's the thing. Like, it's cheaper than hitting another moose. If I hit another moose next week, that's going to hurt my bank a lot. But I could just buy a moose bumper and just hurt my bank a little bit, or I could risk hurting it a lot, you know what I mean? I don't like to spend all the money I have. I like to keep a nice float in there. But we'll see. Anyways guys, so we're gonna head into the city now.
All right guys, I realize there's a bug splat right in front of you. I tried to wipe it off my wipers. Tell you what, every bug that hits my windshield aims for my camera. Oh well, anyways, you get the point. We're here on, the north side of Steinbach, going to my local Freightliner dealer. Good thing I called into Winnipeg. I don't have to go into Winnipeg. We have a local Freightliner dealer right here in Steinbach. So, we're gonna go and order our bull bar from these guys. It's actually not a bull bar, it's a moose bumper. It's better than a bull bar. Bull bars are for pickups. This is a moose bumper. I want the toughest, highest quality, manliest moose bumper this world's ever seen. Now, where's Freightliner? Oh, here's Kubota. I was looking for them the other day. Not that I can afford their tractors, but they're very nice. And we got Case. Look at those tractors on the right, eh? That's a tractor. Try to get that thing stuck. Better yet, try to get that thing unstuck if you get stuck. All right, Freightliner. That is a nice classic right there. Check that out. Trade my truck in for that baby. Nah, I'll be copying Dad. Dad's already got the classic Freightliner. I like that truck, though. What else they got here? I'm going to go inside and talk to the good people. See what we can do about getting us a moose bumper out here. All right, well, we ordered us a moose bumper. Before I started driving, I posted it on Facebook, so if you didn't see it there, well, it's there. I am excited to get the moose bumper out, but at the same time, a little bit pricey. Everything about trucking is expensive. And I'm not complaining, I'm just notifying you guys that you want to get into it. You want to own your own truck? Don't spend all your money. Save every penny you can, because days like this come and you need that money. Anyways, so it is a Herd Road Train bumper, Moose bumper. There are two levels above it yet, but they're too heavy for my liking. I bought the 4-post 3-inch tubing Road Train bumper. There's also a 4-inch tubing 4-post Super Road Train. That weighs 100 pounds more. It's not that much more expensive, but it just weighs 100 pounds more. The one I bought is 370 pounds, which means the Super Road Train would be just under 500 pounds. A little bit much to throw on my bumper on a setback axle like I have. If I had a long classic hood, yeah, I could handle the extra weight up in the front, but a little too heavy. And then there's the big Texas Herd Moose bumper, which is just ridiculous. I mean, you could plow through a brick building with that thing and keep going. I didn't even look into that one. That one's probably about 600 pounds and a bit more expensive as well. But so I got the toughest brand on the market. They're inspired by the Roo bumpers out in Australia. So it is a Moose bumper, which is a mock Roo bumper, sort of. They took the same idea because they're really durable and strength. I mean, really have a lot of strength. And Australia knows how to build Roo bumpers. Except we don't have any kangaroos out here. I've never seen one. I've heard rumors there's one roaming the bushland, but I've never seen it. I'm just kidding. No, there's no kangaroos out here. Though that would be hilarious to capture a kangaroo, like a couple, a male and a female, and let them loose around here. Just to freak people out. Dude, there's a deer in your backyard. That's not a deer, that's a kangaroo. What? I think it'd be hilarious.
Diesel. Were you good, man? Where'd he go? I know you're there.
I thought he was gonna take this cord out. Diesel, we're gonna get a Moose bumper, man. Getting a Moose bumper. Oh, that sounds very nice, man. Very nice. Yeah.
Beware, Moose. Beware. This time I'm ready. Well, guys, you know how I have like plants and stuff growing out of my eaves troughs and out of my gutters because the old owners never cleaned them out? Ever? So there's like mud. There's actually plants growing out of my gutters. My neighbor here was nice enough to borrow me his ladder because I don't have a ladder. So I went and asked him if I could, I saw it leaning on his house. I said, hey, could I borrow your ladder? Oh yeah, anytime, man. You don't even have to ask, man. Just go ahead and use it. Bring him, yeah, you good. Great neighbors here, man. Love this area. So we're gonna get back on the roof again and face my nervousness of being on a roof. It's actually, a roof isn't that bad. I don't like being on heights where I'm not strapped in. And I'm obviously not gonna strap myself onto the roof so I don't fall off. It's way too much work. Besides, I'm a man. I can clean my gutters. It's only like 10 feet high off the ground. Like the roof there is only like 10 feet off the ground, so it's not like it's way up there. So I'll be fine. I'll be fine. So normally, I don't have problems with being on roofs. But I've never had a house with a metal roofing before, right? So pretty much, these bolts are what's keeping me from sliding right off the roof. Like I said, it's only a 10-foot drop down to the bottom there, so it's not like it's the end of the world. But I gotta like scoot right down to the edge here, right? And clean out the gutters. I got this handy little tool here. This is actually my little shovel, my scoop from my snowblower that I showed you when I bought the snowblower. It's to clear out the tube on there. Now we're using it to clear out the gutters. Works just fine. Works like a charm. The one bad thing about metal roofing is hail damage. It's all dented up. Can you guys see that in the video? Little dents. Hail damage.
This would be a great slide if it wasn't for these bolts in here that are holding my holding me in place. We'd slide right down this thing. That's why I wanted to get this done before it snowed, because once it snows, you don't want to be up on a metal roof when there's snow up here. No, not without proper harnesses and whatnot. And we don't need harnesses because we're men, right? We don't need harnesses. Watch my next couple be me lying on the ground. Ouch, yep, needed a harness. Should have had a harness. as I'm scaring you guys, don't be scared. Come on, you wouldn't wear one. It's my roof, my house. Don't have to wear one. I should probably move. Yeah. Let's get this done. If I actually focus and get this done, we can have this done in under half an hour. And take a look at this. Look how much gunk was in the gutters. I've cleaned out that side, you see that? This is what I'm cleaning out now. There was plants growing in here. All coming from that tree there. The neighbor just came over to see how it was going. And he told me that this house was built 4 years ago. They haven't once cleaned these gutters out in 4 years. And it's like built right underneath these trees here, right? So next year I think I'm gonna put gutter guards on here. That's sort of like a screen mesh that goes right over here. Then that keeps the leaves from falling in there, getting trapped in there, but it still lets the water in there, right? So I have to do something. This is ridiculous. Look at that. Filled right to the top. And then we gotta go do the back yet. Oh well. Remember what I said about being an adult and maintaining your house? This is part of it. Keep your gutters clean. I almost said keep your udders clean. So we're on the other side now. I can tell this side's even worse. Nice. Look at all these leaves. Look at that over there. See if it'll zoom in this century. There's plants growing out of that. Not cool. Oh, this thing's got a slow zoom. All right, guys, we're half done. And we just gotta come up here with the water hose yet. And hose everything down. You hoser.
Once again, it's getting late. And this picture's crooked. Diesel, what did you do? I didn't touch it. Who made my picture crooked? I'll straighten that thing out. It's supposed to be straight. My eyes are crooked, I can't see. Okay, there we go. Good enough, whatever. Okay, so I probably look completely beat and completely tired because I just spent the last, when did we start, 8:30? 9:30, 10:30, 11, 3 hours working on the vlogs, working on the YouTube channel and whatnot, and that's my entire evening right there. You spend all day vlogging and you spend all evening editing. And pretty soon I'm gonna have to add driving into that as well again. And add that into the combination. Pretty soon I'm gonna be after doing two jobs again. It's been kinda nice only doing one job for over a week. It's been kinda nice.
Right, Diesel? I don't know what you're talking about, man. As long as I got my cow, I'm good.
You alive, man? You dead?
No, man, I'm just keeping the cow warm, man. He was cold.
I understand.
So, yeah. Yeah, I've had a lot of fun this week at home. I thought that I would get a little bit more, whacked out. Thinking like, oh, I need to get on the road. I have to get on the road. I thought that I'd be like that this whole week. But, really, I've put it into my mind that, this is just an unscheduled vacation. We'll be okay. We learned from our mistakes. We bought a moose bumper. Did I tell you that already? I don't even remember. I probably told you that in the last clip already, right? You want to see my moose bumper? Have you been to my Facebook page? Did you miss it? Oh, I'll show you it. Okay, let's go back to the computer. Why am I sitting on like the worst chair I have? I've been sitting on this chair for 3 hours and I didn't even realize it. I want to sit on a nicer chair. Which one's a nicer chair? This one's a nicer chair. I'll sit on this chair. This is one of my spares. You're supposed to be in the garage. But I had guests over the other day. My family was over and we needed extra chairs. Okay. I put the link on my Facebook, right? So let's go to my Facebook here. Yes, and I just posted this comment as well. There are hundreds of messages in my other box. Guys, I know like hundreds of you, literally hundreds of you have been sending me messages on Facebook. And for some reason, Facebook feels the need to divert them to a separate inbox and it doesn't notify me when they get sent there. So I have seriously like 500 messages in there that I haven't read. So guys, if you've sent me messages on Facebook and I haven't responded, I'm sorry. There's no catching up now. I'm going to try to read as many as I can. But just don't be offended, please. I keep forgetting that they get sent there. And it's just frustrating that Facebook even does that. Like, who is Facebook to judge which messages I should read and which ones I shouldn't? Like, who do you think you are, Facebook? Social media. Whatever. Okay. Anyways, this is what we were looking for, right?
We're going to scroll down to it. Da 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 da. Dun, 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 dun. I don't know why I chose that theme music.
That is somewhat of the bumper that I ordered for my truck. It is from Herd. It is a Herd bumper. Herd, like a herd of cows. Herd bumper. I had 605 likes on this. Now it's 605, 6 and 8. I have 608 likes in this in the last 6 hours, so I must have made the right decision. Let's go to their website here. Some people are saying, yeah, this one specifically here may be for a Peterbilt or whatnot, a long-nosed Pete. But that is pretty much what it's going to look like. It's going to be very square. It's going to have 4-post, 3-inch tubes going across. That is pretty much exactly what it's going to look like. However, it will be custom fit for a Freightliner Sentry. That is the truck that I have. So it will fit onto my truck. And, you know, it'll look good with the truck. It's being specifically built for my truck. So I'm just trying to load this up right now. My internet's kind of slow because I'm uploading 3 videos. Yeah, I know I got 3 days behind, I know. I've edited them every day and rendered them, but... Okay, now this is the Super Road Train. Those are 4-inch tubes. I didn't go with those. Though I'm thinking of calling in tomorrow and changing it. I still might do that. I might change it to the 4-inch tubes, but... It's only like $200 more. But I got the regular Road Train bumper. Which is... Are you gonna... change for me or no? It's this.
Here's the thing. Inspired by the road trains of the Australian Outback, the Herd Road Train provides maximum protection and confidence no matter where you drive. The bolster reinforced lower rake combined with our strongest 18-inch bumper channel will give you confidence wherever you drive. See the Herd Super Road Train for the extreme 4-inch tube version.
That's why I've been tempted to call in and say, hey, 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 wait a minute, wait a minute. Everything in this guy's life is extreme and heavy duty. I might need to go with the Super Road Train. But there is one even bigger than that one yet. It's called, what's it called again? Let's see here. I'll flip you around. Dun, dun. It's called Big Tex. Go figure, Big Texas. It's this, and it is the Herd Big Tex Monster 4-inch tubes in the largest extruded Texas flax style bumper available anywhere. Oversized 4-inch tubes complete the look of this ultra premium product. Well suited for today's forward front axle trucks. And I just spat on my screen while I did that. That's kind of funny.
Yeah, but that one, I'm not really interested in that one. I am, however, interested in the Super Road Train. I might switch it over.
Anyways, guys, I've been talking for long enough, and now I'm just walking around. I know this bothers some of you when I walk around like this, because the background's just going, woo. Oh, dear. Oh, I'm getting dizzy. Oh, let's see how dizzy I can get. Let's see. Oh, this is going to be fun to look at later. Oh, wow, everything's spinning really fast. Are you guys getting dizzy? I'm getting dizzy. Okay. Stop. Oh, everything's still spinning. Whoa, diesel, watch out. Oh dear, my neighbors are probably looking in my window.
Oh, that guy's drunk.
Nope, I'm just dizzy. Just dizzy. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. You know how to get undizzy? You spin the other way. Just a little bit, just like that. Instantly, undizzy. That's the secret. That one's free. Okay, guys, enough of that. I'm just goofing off. I'll see you tomorrow, 4 a.m. Central Time, for a vlog of tomorrow. Tomorrow afternoon,
I'm supposed to be picking up my truck if everything goes according to plan. So, you may see my truck in tomorrow's vlog. You'll have to tune in to find out. See you then.